What is up, fam? Welcome to Roy's channel, where today we're going to be looking at how to two-star using the Town Hall 10 versus Town Hall 12 attack strategies. Now, if you're ready, let's go. Alright fam, here we are hanging out in my clan Hellhorror watching some friendly challenges go on, and Krunk rolls in with some beastly 10v12s, and what I'm gonna do is kind of break these down for you, maybe pause it a few times to show you guys a few things, but this one is for you guys to learn how to scout. Now let's jump in and watch how this takes place. Now he's coming in at the 3 o'clock, which he's noticing he can pull in a few, trash buildings there. Value that you need to grab when doing this, making sure that you guys get that percentage at 50%. What I'll tell you is up at the north side, he brought a bunch of archers in there, picking up that free percentage. You guys need to make sure you have enough archers to cover all those things that are just free. That's absolutely key. Now check it out. With a Town Hall 12, it's probably smart to bring a queen walk in, because that queen will stay alive as long as you can keep her alive to push down as many buildings as possible. Now something I'll tell you, if you're doing a queen walk and you're facing more than 4 defenses, you need to have something else there, most likely tanking for your queen, picking up some of those defensive hits to help the queen stay alive. Now, make sure you have plenty of rages, guys, because once that Giga Tesla punches in, man, that thing is really strong. Without it under a rage, your queen's gonna go down really quickly. Now, check it out. You saw the king there, push down those defenses there, picking up that value. Queen's walking in toward the Giga Tesla, popped the CC. He does have one freeze, so he double poisons the CC troops and beats up more on that Giga Tesla. Now check it out, we are seeing the Ice Golem, something we see a lot today, especially now in the current meta. So we're gonna be pushing that thing down. Now you do see the Queen's being beat up on. He did place that Rage there perfectly, allowing the Queen to stay alive just enough to take that Giga Tesla down. Now check it out, guys, we're at 32%. What more can he do? He's bringing Valks in. Now Valks can clear a ton of those trash buildings. Under heal especially, guys, those things will do a lot of damage. Now watch how much damage those Valks do right now. Under heal and the CC does pop a bunch more bowlers, picking up those structures just inside the wall, which is really important as well, guys, because maybe not all those outside structures are enough to pick up that 50%, but check out what just happened. 50% brought down on this base like a beast. Bringing that Skelly spell in is actually pretty smart, picking up just a few more defenses that maybe he couldn't cover. And there it is, guys. That is a two-star from a Town Hall 10. Great job at Krunk, I'll tell you that right now. There is the composition for you guys. I'll let you look it over for just a second, and we will move on to the next one. Yet again, done by our boy Krunk. Something else you see here is something like this. Now, we do have single target infernos, which you won't see a lot of, but I wanted to show you guys that it is most definitely possible to get through it. You see the Giga Tesla, guys, is nice and deep. Yet again, bringing that queen walk in, but his composition is changed. Now, check out the composition. He's noticing he needs to push that queen walk in, so he's creating that funnel with that baby dragon, taking down that defense very fast, which was really important, especially because you don't want your queen taking too much damage too early, guys. So he's bringing that rage in on the queen. Check it out. He has a ton of troops still left in the composition. How is he gonna get that Giga Tesla? It's actually pretty impressive. Right here shows you guys, if the Giga Tesla is in the center of the base, you can still pick it up. He's noticing he's running into a lot of defenses, so he brings his king in there for some tanking. He out popped a lot of those defenses, so he noticed he probably should freeze them. Smart to keep that queen alive even longer. Queen and king, as you can see, is beating up on the wall, transitions over to that wizard tower, which is great because this helps out a lot in the next phase of the attack. Now check it out, brings a couple baby dragons in there, creating yet again another funnel, which works out really well in this attack. So watch right here, his queen's gonna be walking in towards where that the wall wrecker went in, and is gonna be picking up that, not only all that, those structures there in that south side, but guys, he's gonna bring down that infernal tower and push in towards that Giga Tesla. And this is how you do it, freaking 10v12, very impressive, I'll tell you. I could never have done something like this myself. Queen went in there, helped the Electro Dragon push down the Infernal Tower. You're pushing in those loons at the Giga Tesla now, and that thing's gonna go down really quick. If you guys didn't notice it, let me pause it. He had an earthquake in this composition, which is really important too, to note that no matter the level of earthquake you drop on a Giga Tesla, it brings it down to 75% if you guys did not know. So that's what he did there and helped out a lot, because you can see as soon as that Giga Tesla pops, all his troops die, which it wouldn't have been possible without that earthquake. So check it out, guys. Electro Dragon went in there, finished that off, and there you see Giga Tesla is down, and we're sitting at 49%. A few more cleanups, too easy. He's gonna pick up just over 50% on this brace, bringing in 2 stars. Like a boss, right? So great job to Krunk. We're gonna be watching one more from him, and I'm gonna also give you guys another tip, especially when you're walking into SCCWL. Now check out this one, guys. This one's a slight bit different. You notice the Giga Tesla is on the outside, which in my opinion is absurd. You do not want that thing, because that thing is so strong. Put that thing in the center of the base so that when your troops face it, they're not only facing the Giga Tesla, but they're also facing the defensive structures around the Giga Tesla. Very important to note, especially in SCCWL. So what we're going to be seeing here, guys, is yet again another Queen Walk, very important to have. We have a whole different composition for you today, and we'll see how this one goes down. So he's picking up yet again all those trash building, got there with a few of those troops. He brings that Queen in there to take down the Giga Tesla with the healers. Now, do note, his healers were a little too close. They're being hit by the Giga Tesla. Probably not the best thing to do, but guys, you'll see here, it didn't matter. It worked all too well. Bringing that Loon in there to kind of really pull in any air mines that may be sitting right there. And there you guys go. The Queen pushes towards the 9 o'clock side of this base. Very impressive here, guys, because look at it, what he's pulled in already with just a few, you know, trash buildings on the outside, few archers and such. 31%. Queen's taking down that Giga Tesla going towards the enemy King. And there you see, so much damage was done right there, and 31%, we still have so many troops yet to be laid down. It's very impressive, guys, and very hard to do if you don't know what you're doing. So little tips that I've showed you guys will help out tremendously. He's bringing the King in there inside the his Electro Dragon and the Loon. Again, max Loons are really strong, so pushing them in with a max Electro Dragon will get you a lot of value. Keep that in mind. You're pushing in baby dragons here. Takes a lot for Archer Towers to take them down. They usually get a lot of value, so you know, do keep that in mind as a troop to utilize to keep this attack, the percentage going up. So right here, what I've showed you guys is 3 different compositions for you guys to think about to utilize in your future, you know, Clan War League attacks and so on in regular wars if you're needing to pull that 10v12 in. And there you guys see he's picking up, I think 52% right there on a Town Hall 12. Very impressive. Composition sits right there in front of you. Now, I really hope you guys learned something today, gaining another tool for your toolbox as a Clash of Clanner. Now, please, if you do like what you see, don't forget, before you head out, like, subscribe, comment, do all those things us YouTubers really appreciate, guys. Thank you so much for watching. Roar is out. Stay classy.